In this video, I'm going to be going over some hidden timeline options that you might not be aware of inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So the first one I'm getting asked quite a bit is how do you adjust and save presets for the track height? Sometimes video editors like track heights being at different levels, and with the latest version of Premiere Pro, the new default is relatively larger and it just looks different. So if you work in a certain way and you want to save the way your tracks are, what you can do is adjust your track heights first. Let's say, for example, I like to leave audio track 1 relatively large and the other one smaller, and the same with my video tracks. I'm gonna make video track 1 a little large and the other one smaller. So if I wanna save this track height, you know, video track 1 and audio track 1 being large and the other one small like this, what we can do is once you have your track height set like this, you can go to this wrench icon and then you can click Save Preset. A new window will appear and you can name your preset. So for example, my track height. You can even assign a keyboard shortcut, so if you want to go ahead and do, you know, track height preset 1, you can click OK. And now when you go back to the wrench, you can choose that. Let's say if we minimize all tracks and we want to get back to the way that we were in the other format, we can go back to the wrench and go to my track height. You can see that it changes to that. And what's really nice is that you can save several. So if you work in different types of video editing projects, you can save multiple presets and adjust your track heights automatically and assign keyboard shortcuts to that. And just to show you, if you want to set that as a keyboard shortcut, you can go up to Premiere Pro keyboard shortcuts and then type in track height. And then you can assign a keyboard shortcut to track height 1. You can maybe do 1, for example, the keyboard or the multicam. If you don't use multicam edits, you can change your multicam edits to your track heights. You can click OK. And say if something changes here, you know, that gets really large or, you know, small, we can just click 1 on our keyboard and then that changes back to our saved preset. So hopefully that's helpful for you guys. Another thing that I use inside the wrench icon and what I like to turn on is what's called see-through edits. See-through edits are essentially edits or cuts on your timeline, but they're through edits. They're not like jump cuts. And I like having this visible inside my timeline. Let me show you what I mean. So let's say if I go and zoom in on this timeline here, you'll notice this little icon here. It's like two little triangles. What this indicates is that this is a through edit, meaning that the other side of the cut is the same as the other side of the cut. Like if we just enabled this, it would be like a through edit. You know, say if I get my razor tool and I make cuts, you can see this is the same audio piece. It's just a cut, but it's the cut on the same audio track. It's not like a jump cut where, you know, let's say if we trim one of these and slide it over, you'll notice that that doesn't appear. It's not a through edit. That's what a through edit is. And if you want to turn that on, these little triangles, what you can do is go to your wrench icon and then go to Show Through Edits. And by default, this is off, so I like having this on so I can see the through edits and the jump cuts separately. Or I should say maybe the hard cut separately, where it is visible that it is definitely a different piece of either audio or video. All right, so that does it for this menu. The next menu I'm gonna go into is the hamburger menu. So there's a lot of different options in here that I like to turn on or turn off at certain times. The first one I wanted to show you was show audio time units. This is very helpful if you need to zoom in and make precise edits when it comes to audio. Let me show you how this works. So if you enable this, you'll notice that your time code changes to samples. So we're now in audio samples rather than frame rate. You know, our frame rates are like typically 24, 29 frames a second. But with samples, you can zoom in and make more precise edits to your audio clip specifically. So, you know, if we scrub our timeline and we zoom in, you can see we zoom in all the way to the samples of the audio. You can make precise edits. If you go one sample at a time, you'll notice that this is changing one sample at a time if we use the left or right arrow on our keyboard. So that's a good way, let's say if you're aligning music clips, trying to cut right on the beat, or mixing different pieces of audio together, that's very handy to do that. But I only turn that on at certain points when I need it. Typically, I leave that off and it's just displayed in normal, you know, time code here. Now, let's say if you need to change the start, you know, by default, Premiere Pro has it start at 0000, but if you want to add a 1 or, you know, you want to offset it for some reason, you can always go to the hamburger menu and go to start time. And this enables you to change the start time. For example here, maybe we want to add 1 hour to the beginning. I know this is how I believe DaVinci Resolve is, where it starts at 1 hour. You can change the start time if you need to, and that's how you would do that. A few other options in here I wanted to cover. There's this rectified audio waveform. So if you want to change the way that the waveform is represented in the timeline here, you can see that the audio waveform starts at the bottom and goes up. You can change it to be coming from the center by going and changing that off. And you'll notice that you see it from kind of the center rather than the bottom. So that's just a personal preference if you prefer one or the other, depending how you want to display your audio. So that's another option there. Now, another thing that you can change, not only the audio waveforms, but how the video thumbnails are displayed. So if we go to our hamburger menu, you can change from video head and tail thumbnails to video head thumbnails. So if we change it to that, you'll notice that the thumbnail is only at the front of the video, whatever the first frame of the cut is. And let's say if we change it to continuous video thumbnails, you'll notice that the thumbnail updates throughout the timeline here. So, you know, as I move or as there's different things in my scene here, it'll update accordingly in the timeline. So this is helpful if you are working with specifically long pieces of clips and it changes quite often, this is a good way you can turn that on to see how your clip changes over time rather than trying to scrub and find where different things are in your timeline here. Now, one other thing that I like to do when it comes to my timelines is use what's called pancake sequences. So as you can see here, I have two timelines open here. Let's say I'm working on this timeline here, or this sequence, and I want to add in B-roll clips or my screen recording from this timeline. To easily click and drag clips from this timeline into this timeline, what you can do is rearrange your workspace or your panels to display this above the other panel. So when we click and drag and release when it's above it, you can see both timelines are displayed at the same time. And what we can do is easily just click and drag in from this timeline into this timeline. And that essentially copies clips over. This is very helpful if you work with B-roll clips a lot. So that's a very handy tip there. Now that's just one of the tips that I really like to do, but if you want to learn my best video editing tips, I did make a video going over the absolute best things that you can use inside Premiere Pro. I will link that video right up there. But that does it for this video. Hope you enjoyed. We'll see you guys next time. Take care.